them out. Liam O'Donoghue has discarded his helmet. Just checking as they come out, I don't notice any new members. There may be some switches. That's John Flanagan, who went off in the first half. He's gone over to the right. Mossy Carroll just come out. Noel Drumgoole putting his glasses on there. Noel, the manager of the Limerick team. And walking up the far side of the field now, up towards the hill, is Pat Hartigan. But here come the Galway men with Joe Connolly, Michael Keneally. Out they trot now. And looking to see if there are any new faces there. No way. Sean Silk. And they are just checking the players coming out. I saw Joe McDonough coming along there, just wondering for a moment, was he being promoted to active service? But no, he's just a sub. And there's Iggy Clark. Iggy Clark with the arm in a sling there. The man who, but for an injury here in the semi-final, would be out there doing his bit as one of the great men of Galway hurling. And great man he is too. Half-time score, Galway 2-7, Limerick 1-5. Galway playing from right to left in the second half. And the second half is on. Gone back, Sean Foley. In now to Liam O'Donoghue. Liam without the helmet in this half, and the pass going totally astray there. Well, they breed footballers in Galway too, Seamus Cole. Ryan Carroll trying to get onto that one before it goes over the line. He succeeds. But the positional play of the Galway men certainly been very effective so far today. Frank Burke. Noel Lane. Lucky to get a second go at it. If he does. Mossy Carroll trying to tap the ball up there. Dom punched the ball across the goal mouth, and a good effective clearance on the wing there. And out it comes, Galway being pressed at this stage. Michael Connolly. Joe Connolly. High and over the bar, another point for Galway. Joe Connolly the scorer. The number of Galway points that have come from way out the field. That's what puts Galway 2-8 to Limerick's 1-5. Tommy Quaid with the puck out. PJ Malloy and Liam O'Donoghue. Line ball here for Limerick. Eamon Cregan gone full forward in the, oh dear, how unlike Liam O'Donoghue. The ball didn't go 10 yards and screwed out over the sideline. Line ball for Galway, and Seamus Cohen standing there ready to take. Liam O'Donoghue. And tackled after the ball was gone. And I don't think he's too bad somehow. No. Mossy Carroll to take this free. And Limerick, a goal for Limerick now would really electrify an already hopping game. Mossy Carroll. Ball grabbed by Brian Carroll. A dangerous ball deflected over the bar by Eamon Cregan for a point. A point by Eamon Cregan, who certainly has been the scorer-in-chief for the Limerick men today. The score, 2 goals and 8 points to Limerick's 1 goal and 6, and 1 goal and 5 have been scored by Eamon Cregan. Listen to the crowd. What a puck out. Just the same, or maybe a little bit more than Tommy Quaid's in the first half. Michael Connolly. Joe Connolly. referee had blown his whistle. The referee had blown his whistle for a foul, and there is a free out for Limerick from just inside their own 45-meter line. Penalised Joe for going a little bit too far with the ball in his hand. Mossy Carroll against the wind. But it's still a good one. Steve Mahon can't get it away. Joe McKenna. Ollie O'Connor. Not his day so far. Joe McKenna out now to the far wing. Gone out to try to get it. Willie Fitzmaurice. And the ball grabbed by Michael Connelly, but his clear is blocked down. Michael Connelly. That's Paddy Fitzmaurice. And that's why. 14 points to 9. 2-8 to 1-6. Paddy, who had a breakaway there, a chance for a point, and it just didn't come. And that's the big difference. Galway taking their opportunities from way out the field. Limerick not doing so. Long puck out, knocked down by Sean Foley. Goes to Joe Connolly. And Joe Connolly doesn't take this opportunity. He sends it wide. 14 points to 9 points. 5 minutes gone, second half. 2-8 to 1-6. Mossy Carroll, left half back. Sean Foley, centre half back, to try and watch Joe Connolly. That's the latest move in the Limerick team. Mossy Carroll up the wing and out over the sideline. And I thought for a moment there was a substitute coming in the far side, but no, Cyril Fardell, one of the mentors of the Galway team. And in fact, he is the manager of this team, giving a few words of advice there, and certainly his advice is his team 2-8 to 1-6 in front of this stage. Oh, what a puck! What a lovely shot, way, way up the field. Sean Foley gone back to get it. Out over the line. Paddy Lynch, the linesman, signaling a line ball. Sylvie Lennon going up to take it. It's high, and it has gone wide. Wide, and Sylvie racing back to take his position so that he's back on his man before the puck out comes his way. Jimmy Carroll out there waiting to see will it come his way. Tommy Quaid sees that it does. But Steve Mahon gets it away from him. No lane. Bernie Ford in under it over there with down punch. From way out the field, from about 45 meters out there, taken off by Bernie Ford, and Captain Joe Connolly isn't satisfied yet. He wants to keep them at it, and I don't blame him. Galway 2-9, Limerick 1-6. And the crowd really getting behind the teams as the ball drops center field. PJ Malloy. Out over the end line and wide. I wonder, are they right? Hook out far side of the field. Sylvie Lennon. Emo Donahue up the field now with it. Billy Fitzmaurice. Joe McKenna, but in the master position there and getting the ball out. Under defensive pressure over there on the far side with Sean Silk. This is Brian Carroll, who came on as a sub just before the interval. And here comes Pat Herbert into the game. Pat Herbert coming on for the Limerick man. And going off is Mossy Carroll.